Do your clients want more detail on the invoices that you send them when you bill them for job-related expenses? Well, then you need to know how to bill for expense items. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comment section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Expense items are items that vendors provide for us and they get placed on a check, expense, or bill from a vendor at the moment we purchase the item. The item is attached to an expense type of account the same way that income items are attached to an income account and placed on an invoice for service when we give to the clients. So, we know what the items list looks like. QuickBooks Online calls it the lists of products and services. And we know that we put in the new items by putting in their name. And when you put their name, we also put an income account that was associated with that item so that when you put the item on the invoice, the related income account increases. And these were the windows that were open when we set up our list of products and services at the beginning of the course. Now, expense items are the same as income items, except they are attached to expense accounts and they're placed on checks, bills, and expenses instead of invoices. Now, you may well ask, why do we need expense items? Well, we use expense items because up until now, billable expenses had only the expense account listed on the transaction. There was no detail about the items purchased. There was no detail that shows on the client invoice when billing for them. If we use an item, however, we will have more detail and the detail shows on the invoice so the client can see what expense they are being billed for. For example, we have an expense account called Indoor Job Materials. We're going to add this in a moment. Now, we could bill the client for just indoor job materials, but it would be better if we listed the specific things that we bill them for that count as indoor job materials, like window panes and brackets and sheetrock and so on. So the indoor job materials is the account, and if we bill the way we did earlier in the video, the client would not have a lot of detail on their invoice. But if we broke it up into identifiable items and listed the items themselves and the quantity on the invoice, then the client would have a better sense of exactly what they're being billed for in the way of reimbursable expenses for their job. Now, each expense item has two sides. There's the expense side that you would connect to an expense type of account, and then you would put in the purchase price when you're purchasing it. Then you'd have to put in the income side of the item, which means you would connect it to an income type of account and put the price we charge the client when we bill. For example, let's add two accounts for this new thing called indoor job materials. First, we'll add indoor job materials expense, and the detail type will be other business expenses. Then we'll add indoor job materials income, and the detail type will be other primary income. And these will be the two accounts that our expense items will be tracked to before we record transactions with them. So, very simple. We go down here and we click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, and in the top right we click New. Now we know the first one is going to be an expense type of account, and the detail type is Other business expenses. And the name will be indoor job materials expense. And you can pause the video to type it in if you like. Now we click Save and New, and the other account we put will be an income type of account, specifically other primary income as the detail type, and the name will be Indoor Job Materials Income. And of course, you could pause the video to type it in. Now we click Save and Close, and we have the two accounts that we will connect to our example expense items. Now we're going to add two items to the list of products and services. We will add sheetrock, $3 each for purchase and $5 each for sale, and brackets, $4 each for purchase and $10 each for sale. We will connect them to both the expense account and the income account that we just created, and the specific account type on the list of products and services must be non-inventory type if we're billing for reimbursable expenses with this extra detail. And there are two check marks that we must leave in the item window in order for this to work. One is called "I sell this product or service to my customers," and the other is this one, and you'll see these words and you will leave the check mark. Now, we'll start with the first one, sheetrock, buy for three, sell for five. So we click the cogwheel, we come across to lists, we go down to product and service lists, and then we click new, and make sure that you choose non-inventory part. Now, this name will be sheetrock. Okay, now I'm going to leave the check mark here where it says I sell this product or service to my customers, and we sell the sheetrock at $5 each. Now, the income account associated with this item is the income account we just made, indoor job materials income. Now, we're not finished. We must also check this. I purchased this product or service from a vendor. When you check it, you get the expense side of the data. And you add the cost that we purchase it for. We purchase it for $3 each. And the account that goes up when we purchase is the expense account we just made, indoor job materials expense. We click Save and New. And now we'll do the other item, brackets. We buy for four and sell for 10. So we put the name brackets and we leave the check mark here. We make sure that we put the right sales price, that we sell for 10. And we connect it to the proper income account, the account we just made, indoor job materials income. Scroll down. You must click the check mark to open up the expense section here. We buy this sheetrock, brackets for $4 each. And the expense account that goes up when we buy will be indoor job materials expense. When we click Save and Close, you can rest assured we have both of those items on the list of products and services. And now let's do our example transaction. Let's imagine on January 25th, we purchased 7 units of sheetrock and 5 brackets, each for the purchase cost that we already set up on the items list, so we don't have to change it when we purchase it. They will be billable to the client Brown Company specifically for the Mockingbird Lane job. Okay, so let's go ahead and record this expense. You could record it as either an expense or a check. I'll record it as a check so you can see sometimes you have one check for job materials for two different clients. Now the date will be January 25th of 2021 in our little story, and we are paying Home Depot. And what exactly are we buying? Now, it will be 7 sheetrock and 5 brackets from Home Depot. Watch. Now, be very careful. You see these two triangles? Previously in the course, we only opened the category section and put the expense account here. Let's close it up. Now, instead, we're opening the item section and putting the item details. And notice when you click under product or service, only the two items that were connected to expense type of accounts showed up here. And that's because this window is a check, expense, or bill. So you will not get any account, you will not get any item that's connected to an income account, only to an expense type of account. How many units of sheetrock? 7 of sheetrock and 5 brackets. Sheetrock quantity 7, brackets quantity 5. Now they are both billable specifically to which job? I believe we said Mockingbird Lane job under Brown Company. So the customer will not just be Brown Company, it'll be the Mockingbird Lane job. And you can make it for two different jobs and even two different clients. Notice, it tells you what the markup is and so on, but don't worry, your clients won't see these item details either on the expense or on the invoice. So now that we recorded this the way we're supposed to after creating the item, let's predict what the results will be in the trial balance. Well, this is the first time we're buying indoor job materials. So indoor job materials will show up for the first time as $41. And if your cash and bank is already negative and you pay $41, it will become $41 more negative, and that should be the result if my numbers match yours after this very simple purchase. So this is the way to record it. We click Save and Close, and then we click Reports, Trial Balance, and you can see indoor job materials expense showed up for the first time as $41, and I hope we have the same number in cash, $1,039. However, we're not finished after we check the trial balance. You also have to check the profit and loss by client to make sure the expense was tracked properly. So you click Reports, Profit and Loss by Customer. Now we're going across to the Mockingbird Lane job, and here we are in the Brown Company Mockingbird Lane job, and go down to the expense section, and you can see under Mockingbird Lane, we have $41 of indoor job materials expense. Now we will bill Brown Company for the Mockingbird Lane job materials. So let's imagine on January 30, we bill Brown Company for the indoor job materials. We charge him $5 per sheetrock and $10 per bracket, which is the way that we actually set it up. Remember, you could change these numbers at the moment that you bill them. So, what will happen in the trial balance at the moment we put these items on a bill? Well, according to the numbers that we have, it'll be a total of $85 gross that we're billing them for, because we marked them up when we set up the items list. So what does that mean? It means that indoor job materials income, the account we created, will show up for the first time as $85, because that's the amount we're billing the company for, our client, for these expenses that will be listed on the invoice. And of course, because the client owes us more as a result of the invoice, accounts receivable will increase by $85 and become 18,938. And we will get these numbers, and all we have to do is place the two billable items on the invoice. We click New, Invoice. And the date in our little story is January 30th. It's under Brown Company, the Mockingbird Lane job. Aha! Notice on the side here, each individual billable expense that was on a separate line of the check is listed separately. This way we could bill for each individual line, and it's possible that each line on the previous expense could have even been for a different client. But in this case, we're going to add both of them to the same invoice, to the same client, and we will see that the total of the invoice is $85. Now, don't worry about the way it looks. It specifically says here, your customer won't see this regarding the markup, but you will see it, and you'll see the results when we go to save it. So, at the moment I click Save and Close, we can open the trial balance by clicking Reports, Trial Balance, and you can see the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. Indoor job materials income shows up for the first time as $85, and indoor job materials expense didn't change. And what's owed to us in accounts receivable is exactly as what we expected. And when we click Reports and we go to the Profit and Loss by Customer, in the column of Mockingbird Lane, you see you now have indoor job materials income as $85 and the original $41 in indoor job materials expense did not move. Now, that brings me to my final point about the differences between using items and using expenses. Very important point. You see, expenses will increase when we purchase expense items, and no matter what, income will increase when we bill for them. That's it. We do not have the option to change this if we're using items. Please note, the account settings are not relevant regarding billing for expense items, which is differently than the way we learned to bill earlier for reimbursable expenses. You see, previously we used this option and we opened account settings in the expense section and we saw this check mark in earlier videos. That choice is only relevant if you're billing and using the expense accounts instead of using expense items. So earlier in the course, this check mark was very important. But now that you're using expense items, this check mark will not affect anything. Expenses go up when we buy, income goes up when we bill, and the expense stays the same regardless of this check mark, because we are now using items for extra detail instead of just the accounts. You can learn everything you need in QuickBooks regarding contractor features by watching the full playlist that this video is a part of. You can just click the link in the comment field or under the first paragraph in the description field, and there's also links in the top right of the video as it plays.